That's what we're
seeing. As the sun sets over the San Fernando Valley, we're here in Los Angeles, California. The time is 8 o'clock Pacific Daylight Time. That is 8 o'clock in Los Angeles.
I want to jump in and say that's the real sunset you're looking at right there. I'm looking at that, and I can see it in the monitor, and yeah. I'm looking at the same thing.
It's about a 20-second delay. That's the time it takes for the computer to buffer. That's the actual internet you're looking at, Andy. The voice, ladies and gentlemen, that you hear, cut to camera two, is Andy Dick on the show today. So,
uh-oh.
Yeah. Now, oh, wow, look at that. It's already showing up there. Look at that. Cool. Well, so move that away.
I guess it's more of a seven. Yeah.
But how you doing, man?
7 seconds.
Here we are.
Delay. Well, it's a 7 seconds delay, I think.
Is it seven? How long?
You know what? It doesn't really matter.
How long is the delay,
Robert? It doesn't really
matter.
It doesn't really matter. I'm sorry I brought it up. We have much more important things to talk about. This is my dime.
Yeah. This is, you know, we can take calls, okay?
Well, first, can I talk about why I wanted to see you again?
Yes.
Because last time I saw you was in a club.
What? Where was that?
And my girlfriend made out with you.
No, that's not true.
Yes, it is.
This can't keep happening. I mean,
you don't remember. Remember the girl from The Assistant, the TV show? She was like, you and Harlan. She was all over both your nuts.
I don't remember.
You don't
this.
Remember? You
don't
were
remember
out of
this.
Your mind that night.
I don't remember this.
You're out of your mind. I'm not kidding, people.
Okay. Well, I apologize.
Of the Worldwide Intro Network.
Is that actually a true story, though? Okay.
No, it really is. Okay. I'm not kidding.
That's
you must. I think you were done. No, it's not. She was a what?
Yeah.
Well, obviously, I'm with her on a date.
Right, sure.
She starts making out with you and Harlan.
Me and wait.
And Harlan Williams.
I think I do remember that actually.
See?
But I never.
But I went home, and I'm the one that fucked her.
Yeah, I never.
I'm the one that fucked her.
I know.
That's the clincher.
I never did anything.
That's the pincher.
So wait, we can take phone.
This is what
calls.
I did to her that night. I'll try. To imagine where I was pinching.
Yeah. I mean, can we get a close-up of that? Is that possible? You know, of that? This is.
I mean, my fingers are turning white.
This is exactly what
I'm like white knuckles. See? I'm not pinching softly there.
Do you have a shot of it now? Or can you turn the monitor around? Let's see the monitor. We want to see the monitor. Let's take a phone call.
What's that monitor? Oh, yeah, let's see that.
Let me tell you
something.
I want to show you how this works,
Andy. He's got this set up. Sweet.
Yeah, isn't he? Look at this. Oh, look how it works. Alex from Austin, Texas. Yeah.
Oh, I don't want to talk to anyone about it.
Hey, Andy, what was your scariest experience growing up?
Your scariest?
Okay. I'll answer that. I thought he was gonna.
No, it's fine.
Talk about the last time I was in Austin a couple months ago.
Why? What happened?
Well, if I wanted to talk, I won't want to talk about it.
Oh, you don't want to talk about it?
No.
Okay.
That's why I was worried that he was gonna bring it up.
Hey, I didn't know. Okay, so what was the scariest childhood memory then? You don't even care about that. Who cares?
Well, I'm just thinking
about that's
how,
a bad question.
No, yeah, you know what? Actually, I wish he would have brought it.
It's a boring question.
You know how many stories there are of me in Austin, Texas, floating around right now?
Like what? What would one be that you could say, that you could part with?
I really don't want to bring it up because none of them are true.
Okay. You can call us at 866-626-4254. I'm here with Andy Dick.
This is live, man. I just love that.
See, there's nothing on the internet that's live like that. That's a toll-free number.
I want to hear from somebody from Australia.
Can someone from Australia?
Anybody.
Call?
I don't give a
anyone.
One good goddamn who.
Any what? Australian. We got a
you
guy.
You could be an Aborigine calling from.
You want to hear a guy from Ireland? Ireland.
Go ahead, caller.
He's asking you about when your film is coming out in Europe. Rob from Ireland.
How are you guys doing?
We're doing great.
Fantastic.
Yeah, I have a question for Andy. How did your movie do in the States, Danny Rohn, and is it coming out in Europe?
Oh, that's so sweet. First of all, I love how you say my name. I just love it. It's so soft and it's sexy. You say Andy. Did you hear that?
Yeah, no, it's very nice.
I love it. I'm going to make all my friends. What is my name?
Andy, yes.
I love it.
Andy Dick. You know, my father's name. My father's name was Dick.
I know.
Dick Green,
right?
Yeah.
Richard.
I read a little bit of your biography today. You know that online?
I didn't
Googled
write a biography.
It. Oh,
what you Google
talk
does
about
not.
About you running for a student's council.
That's not my. I didn't write a biography. That's just what people write about
me. I talked about you running for student's council and vote for a Dick. A Dick.
Yeah, don't vote for A Dick. Vote for A Dick.
Oh, yeah.
That was
one year the election.
That was homecoming king.
I was on student's council as well.
But that was homecoming king.
Really?
That's what makes it so funny.
You were homecoming king
for
real?
I was homecoming king.
Really?
Do you understand?
I don't think we have
student
that.
Student councils all
I don't think
fun
we even have
all
that in Canada.
I was what the quarterback of the football team should have been.
Mm. Right, because he was running against you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. He should have won.
Yeah. I feel hey, Rob, do you have anything else
I
to add to this?
I didn't answer his name. I have to tell
He's
him.
Still there.
Rob.
Yeah?
Thank you for acknowledging the fact that I wrote and directed a movie. And I said I wasn't even going to talk about it, but he brought it up.
Yeah, I saw the trailer today on your website.
Oh, thanks.
Yeah, andydick.com.
You told me you liked it.
Yeah, it's awesome.
Blowing smoke up my skirt.
No, it was awesome. Thanks, Rob. Thanks for calling.
But I want to tell him that, yes, it will come out. It's going to have a world. It has the Weinstein people want it, Sony, Columbia TriStar, not Sony, Columbia TriStar, Think Films. They did The Aristocrats.
Yeah.
I have four offers.
Really?
To buy it. Yeah. And
probably you'll have three tomorrow after this broadcast. But
but from, like, Bangladesh.
Yeah, no. Hey, come on, here. Taiwan from New Jersey is on the phone.
Taiwan. Wait, maybe his name is New Jersey and he's from Taiwan.
Hello, sir, are you there?
Yeah, and Andy and Tom?
Yes,
Are you in Taiwan?
Yes, I am.
Really?
Yeah. What?
Are you in New Jersey or Taiwan?
Say that again, man.
Are you in New Jersey or are you in Taiwan?
Yeah, I'm in Jersey, but my name's Taiwan.
Oh, your name is Taiwan, yeah.
Boring.
Anyway, I had a question for you, Andy.
Yes?
Just real quick, I want to say this last time to Tom when I called, but I credit you two guys and when Brady for, like, getting me into comedy. I just, like, started writing and stuff like that. So, I really want to thank
very
you.
Very nice. Very nice to hear from you. Yeah. You sound like a good lad. Keep it up.
And my question is, I remember in 2002 you had a band, Andy.
Oh, your band, The Bitches and The Bitches. Andy and The Bitches of the Century.
Is
that what it's called, The Bitches of the Century?
Yes, it is. Andy
Thanks, Thanks, Taiwan.
I'll answer your question.
Yeah.
Andy Dick and The Bitches of the Century. Yeah, that's my band. God, the sunset is absolutely gorgeous now. Can we swing around? Thank you.
Yeah, swing around and show
You've
the sunset.
You've got to see this. Don't show take that. The label off. What are you...
I don't know.
Well, you're going to get in trouble.
We don't actually have any advertisers here. We're looking for advertisers. Arrowhead. We drink Arrowhead water. This is a freebie for you.
Go to the sunset. Right as he says Arrowhead. Yes. Let's make a commercial right now. Ready?
Arrowhead water.
Wait. It'll start. Ready? I'm the director of this. I want you to be... I want you to... It's sexy water.
Okay,
it's gorgeous water. You're thirsty.
Okay, this instead.
You're thirsty. And then we go to the sunset.
No, but this instead, no.
We'll do that then. Then it has to be more
fun.
No, wait,
you got to move it. You're in front of the camera, though.
Shit.
That, right there. Yeah, stand there.
I got to be out of it.
See that camera? See that camera?
Yeah. And then that's how I want it.
Yeah,
come on.
Yeah.
Here we go. I can stand right there.
Yeah, that's good. Okay,
ready? Don't look at me. Look at the camera.
Yeah.
Oh, those are hands. Okay, I got to take my hands. And action.
Oh, well, what am I supposed to do? Swirl berries.
It's happy. You love it. It's a breakfast.
I love these. They are so delicious. Let's see here. Fruity Pebbles from Post. The
Cut
most delicious
sunset.
Cereal.
Cut
I eat this
sunset.
Here every day.
Yes.
When I get up in the morning, I like to have Fruity Pebbles. Start out your day with Fruity Pebbles.
Cut to the fucking sunset, you fucking
cocoa
asshole.
Cocoa Pebbles.
Cut to the fucking... Oh.
Post Cocoa Pebbles.
Did. I'm looking at... See, that's
when
where
I
the
get
second,
up in the morning,
the
I like to get up
delay
and
really fucks
Post
me over.
Cocoa
I yelled
Pebbles,
at him. Let's cut. Cut. I'm the director.
Okay. All right.
Cut.
That was fun, though. I enjoyed that.
You know what? Cut back to me.
Who's calling you right now?
Yeah, well,
wait, do you have any people?
Who is it? Who is it?
Andy, it's Billy.
Oh, great. Okay, well, you're on loudspeaker, so go. What do you need?
Why didn't you come to my masturbation party, my hand job party?
That's wonderful.
Yeah.
That's wonderful. Is that what you can have that on your show?
Yeah, I think you can.
You can't say that on the show.
Why didn't you call me?
What kind of party?
Hand job party.
It's not really
a hand job party. What does that mean?
I don't know who these people are. That
these are my friends.
What kind of disgusting filth is that? Kind of.
What
kind of?
Wait, what are you trying to say?
Filthy.
Oh, it's the whole.
Who is this guy?
I don't know.
Who is this? Do you
get crank calls. He said he got my number on the internet.
Oh, really?
He called me earlier.
I gave out my cell phone number on the internet, too.
Why?
310-717-1919.
Don't.
Give me a call.
I'm not saying mine, and you're not either.
Bye-bye.
Give me a call
on my cell phone, ladies and gentlemen. 310-717-1919. If you want to talk to Andy Dick, you can call us here at 866-626-4254. The sun is dipping over the horizon here.
Oh, that's so
You're
gorgeous.
Watching TomGreen.com.
You've got a gorgeous house,
Mania
Tom.
TV.
Gorgeous
thanks,
house.
Thanks for coming. Thanks for being
I
here.
I love it.
Yeah, you're going to come back, you said. You said you're going to come every
I want to be a weekly guest. Look, we were having a
you
little fun.
You can do
fun.
Characters as well.
I don't. What we just did, that's goofy.
You
need help.
You can do a different character.
No,
every
I need
week.
Help.
I know you wanted to talk about
I want to talk about my personal things.
Yeah, absolutely.
And, I mean, this is all fun and games and whatnot. Maybe that's my therapy.
You're serious about this. Andy was saying to me when he got here.
I had a brain fart, and I said, I'm not going to hire a therapist. I'm just going to come up here once a fucking week.
Yeah.
I'm just going to let it all hang out.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. Listen, I'm a good listener.
And can I tell you?
Yeah.
Well, I'm overwhelmed.
Uh-huh.
I have 3 kids.
Yeah, okay.
You know, so, and I guess I'm going to be taking care of them full time.
Okay. What's going on?
My ex needs to, she doesn't really have a phrase for it. Find herself. She doesn't. I wish she'd give me something.
Right, right, right.
But basically,
is she in town here in LA?
Yeah, she lives in Topanga Canyon. Mm. She's a wonderful. I love her. She's great. She's a great mother. Which is
how old
why.
Are they? How old are the kids?
12 and 8. Oh,
okay.
You know, my theory is that now that they're not little cuddly little babies anymore.
Yeah.
Dad, time for you to take over.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. And so that's a lot of work. I have a parrot, which is just driving me up the wall. So I can imagine.
It's beautiful, actually. And he's very quiet. He's not one of those squawkers.
Yeah, well, he does have his moments. Yeah, he has his moments. Rex Murphy is my parrot.
You squawk it up?
Green Wing Macaw over here.
Are you going to squawk it up?
Here, let's take a call and we'll continue this check. So, what do you want me to. What do you need to work out then, Andy?
Is he nice? Is he nice or is he mean? Is he going to
He may bite you, yeah.
Like break in half.
Yeah, I mean, I'll bring. You want me to get him out? Get the.
No, no, he just said he may bite you. No.
No, it's okay. No, he won't bite me. He's fine. Just go here. He's fine. Here. Rex Murphy, come here.
He's biting you.
No, he's not. He's just being playful. Come here. Where's the perch? Yes. Do we have that? Where's the perch there?
I love animals.
So what? So you're
don't
overwhelmed?
Make him, don't make him bite me to
no,
be
he
funny.
Bite, he won't bite you.
Because it wouldn't be funny to me. Shit, I'm going to put my phone on silent.
Hey, do you know any famous people we can call?
Yes, I do.
You want to call some?
We should. Dude, I got to hang up. Yeah, let me find some. Let me put this on silent.
Who are some famous people in Andy Dick's cell phone that we could call?
All right. Well, let's save that for. I got a lot of them.
Okay, we'll do it on another.
We'll do one. Yeah, we'll do one. We'll start down here. Okay, buddy?
Yeah, okay.
Look at me.
Here's a call
buddy,
for you.
Look. We're going to start down here and we're going to climb up.
Yeah, absolutely. No,
we're going to get all the way up to Ben fucking Stiller.
Yeah.
And then maybe beyond that.
Look, we can go. I don't know. We can go all night. We can go all night here. We can keep going.
No, you can.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's an hour.
This is my little.
He just said hello.
No, it's hello. I know he said hello. Okay, Rex, I'll just put you up here. Okay, like that. Okay?
He just said hello.
And someone, yeah, he said hello. It's she actually. She laid an egg the other day.
No.
Yeah, absolutely. I thought it was a male.
Wait.
Parrot. Honestly, I thought it was a male parrot.
You laid an egg, then you have to rush over a male, right, to fertilize it?
I don't
and
know.
And you could have a baby macaw.
I honestly don't know how it works, but it just, I got up in the morning, there was an egg sitting there in the bottom of the cage.
And you said, great, side up.
Yeah, yeah.
Did you fry it up and eat it?
Yeah, it actually never lay an egg, but I thought that would be a cool story, and I just threw that out there in the moment. And then I started feeling guilty about it, and I realized that was just a... I'm sorry.
You would have fried
Wait,
it
do
up.
You have any people that you can...
Yes, I have somebody in mind, actually.
We have
do I call today who... I called him yesterday. He called me back today, but I was in the bathtub.
Right.
Trying to, calganize it away.
We have a guy from Massachusetts on the air who wants to ask you a question. Bill? What?
Yeah, Andy.
Yeah. Oh, wait, I never answered the other guy's question. For the other guy, Andy Dick and the Bitches of the Century just signed a 2-CD deal with a company called Olio, but it's spelled O-G-L-I-O. And the first one... Boom, it's coming out like within a month. It's just this live shit that I do. When I do live shows, I just go there and I just talk. The thing is that people say, hey, come out to our college or come out to our comedy club, come here. And they offer me tons of money
to go for an hour. Really?
And I go, well, I don't really have an act. And they go, we don't care. Here's the money.
Then
I go there. I'm like, I really don't have an act. I'm going to go up there and just talk. And they go, who cares? We'll double it.
Right.
You shut up and come out here, we'll double it.
And
I go out there. I go on stage and I do just talk.
Yeah.
And then they go, we're not fucking paying you.
Really?
Well, sometimes.
Really?
Sometimes I offend them so much.
I had a similar experience to that.
No,
I was asked to go to Lincoln, Nebraska one time for a Pepsi One campaign, and I was in these commercials when I first came. Yeah, and so they said, come out to Lincoln, Nebraska. We're having the Cornhuskers are having their big,
throw off for the big, the you know, the, some whatever they do in the football there when
oh,
they do the stuff.
Oh,
you
there's
know.
A football
there's
team.
A big thing,
Cornhuskers.
Yeah, and a big team out there. And they said, come on out to our pep rally or whatever it is, you know, which I'm thinking, and just hang out and sign some autographs or whatever. You know, that was all I was supposed to
right.
do. You know, that was
that
all.
Doesn't sound bad.
So, and I'm
and,
like,
and
okay,
a bunch
but
of money.
I, yeah, yeah.
They
well,
threw you a bunch of money.
It was sort of part of the deal with the commercials. I had to make a couple of public appearances or something. Yeah.
I have an
you know,
important
was,
question.
Hey, but you
okay,
know,
you're, we're getting right
you know,
to
it's
it.
Funny. I got there, and then they asked me to go out and do like an hour in front of 15,000 people. So I ended up getting kicked out of the place. For like humping a mascot or something
yes,
like that,
exactly.
And they got I didn't realize I was I'm from Canada. I didn't realize I was in the Bible Belt.
Yeah,
and I humped the mascot, and
time.
Then the next day it was like blasphemy.
Exactly.
I'm like, you guys just asked me to come and hang out, and then you put a mic in my hand. I had nothing. A mascot came by, started humping my leg. What am I supposed to do? You know. So
that's what.
Yeah.
Next time you tell that story, get to that mascot humping.
Quicker, yeah, yeah,
quicker.
Absolutely, yeah, yeah.
For sure.
No,
I'm going to call Bob Odenkirk, by the way.
Okay, call him.
But not yet. Well, we got to answer this guy. So anyways, Oglio, spelled O-G-L-I-O, two more albums. One of them is all spoken word. The shows that we were just talking about where I just go out there and talk. I've got
here.
One where I'm drunk and one where I'm sober. One side is when I'm drunk and one side is when I'm sober. One you know, side of the album.
Oh, okay, cool.
Whatever.
Oh, really? And you really did that?
I didn't do it on purpose.
Yeah.
I just happen to have these two great recordings.
Where
and
do you
both of them are funny, uh-huh. but in a different way.
You're
and I don't. I would wonder if you would know which one I was drunk in and which one I was sober. I'm not kidding. Like,
no,
I had
it.
To think real hard.
Sometimes when you're playing music, it's a little easier to loosen up and have a...
Yeah, no, but this is me just talking. And
okay.
and yes, there is music, though. I have some yeah. friends who play some
you
music.
You play music as well?
I don't play, but I sing
songs.
So, but those albums are coming out. Oh, and then the second one is all music. The second one is
okay,
all music.
Let's blow through some calls. We can talk about that in a minute.
Okay, does that answer? He didn't answer. We didn't
answer. I know, but we got everyone's calling. We got thousands of people calling. We got to take some calls here real quick. Yeah, like hundreds of thousands.
Let's try to answer them.
You know, we got the same phone system as American Idol here. Yep, absolutely. Yep. A couple of days ago, we had a different phone system.
Wow.
The thing went down because we were getting too many calls, so
this
we had to get a new system.
Pretty.
Yeah, look at this. You can touch the thing
sweet.
Here with the
well,
little thing.
Let me see who's calling.
Okay.
Great.
How'd Andy start at MTV?
No,
Tim.
From Canada.
You're on the air.
Canada.
You have a question from from.
Where are you from?
Canastrot. Canastrot.
Minnesota?
Yeah.
I'm going to Minneapolis on Saturday.
Why does it say... Okay,
is that
yeah.
near you?
No, I'm in New York.
Okay.
I thought you just said Minnesota.
Do you have a question, or are we just going to sit here and sort of listen to each other?
How did you get your start at MTV?
My start? I did those short films in the movie awards, the video music award, the VMAs, the video music awards,
and then
the movie awards later. Just those short films.
It was like a slick look.
I was kind of
shot
like,
it all on
I was,
film or something. It
yeah,
like
it always looked good.
Yeah.
I was on a show called News Radio, and the show was kind of critical hit, and people thought my character was really funny, and so then they liked me.
But
at
you'd
the
done
time.
Stuff.
They liked
on
that's
you've
back,
done the Ben Stiller show before on MTV
yes,
too, though, right? That was
back,
MTV as
that,
well, right?
Mm-hmm, that's
I
back.
Didn't have MTV in Canada growing up as a child.
No, that wasn't MTV. The Ben Stiller show
oh,
was on
Fox.
Fox.
Oh, it was. Okay. Yeah, you're right. I knew
but,
that. You're right. It wasn't Fox.
We're talking about a time when they used to love me.
How long
and
ago was that? When that show
enough.
Came on Fox.
A long time.
A long time ago. Yeah. Yeah.
But anyways.
Are you okay or what?
No, I need to talk to you about a lot of things.
No, I mean seriously. We don't have to take calls if you don't want. You can.
I
want to
take calls because I want to feel like I'm traveling the world.
Yeah, we'll.
I think that will be good for my therapy. I think that'll be a good part of it. Laughing, having fun, letting it all hang out, taking a few calls. Like I feel like I'm on an Australian beach.
Yeah.
Is there anyone from Australia?
There's no one from Australia. There's a guy from LA.
I hate Australia.
We got a guy from a girl from Milwaukee. Someone from Florida.
Well, what does this guy want? Oh,
Jeffrey
MTV.
From Oklahoma,
so,
Jesse from New York, Joe from Florida, Chris from L.A., Michelle from Milwaukee. Michelle, who do you want to talk to?
Just let's go backwards.
These people are calling to talk
let's
to you.
Go to Michelle right
go to
away,
Michelle.
And then we'll work up.
From Milwaukee.
And then we'll go to Bob Odenkirk.
Yeah.
From Los Angeles.
Yeah, I know. We want
Should
him to come
him
on
home
the show
first.
Too. Ask him to come over right now.
He won't. He's,
no,
he's got kids. He's a family man.
Tell him to go
he goes
look
home,
on the
he
internet.
Has dinner. His wife is cooking up meatloaf
Tell him
right
to go
now.
Look on the internet.
I will. You want me to call him now?
See what we're talking about and tell him.
I'm calling him now.
Does he live nearby?
Because you're not taking this guy's call.
No,
he does live nearby.
Yeah,
he lives
in
the hills.
Tell him to zip over here.
As you do.
Syl from New York City.
Oh, wait. I'm already calling Bob.
Hello?
Yeah, we can talk to everybody at once. Go. Yeah, yeah. We're just going to hang up with these people anyways. Hi.
I just want to give props to you and Andy. I think that you both had really great shows. Too bad they stopped showing, but I wanted to know, whatever happened to Andy's show?
Which one?
What happened to your show?
I hate when people say that, because I always have to say, which one?
And then
they go, what do you mean? Well, you're talking about News Radio,
yeah.
Get Smart, Ben Stiller's show, The Assistant, or The Reality Show.
Which show were you talking about?
Bob Odenkirk didn't answer his cell phone.
Oh, that was him?
The Andy Dick Show.
It got canceled, you know. We did 20 episodes. That's a lot of fucking episodes, dude. Mm-hmm. You know how many episodes Mr. Show did? Bob Odenkirk, Mr. Show? How many do you think they did? They did a lot, remember? They were on for years.
Yeah, let's say it's probably an amazingly small number or something, like 26 or something.
30.
Like 30,
yes.
Yeah.
Because you couldn't tell I was tricking you.
Yeah, I could tell you were tricking me. Yeah.
You're good. Huh? That's why I want you to be my doctor, because you're
so
good.
You've been
through trouble, too.
Yeah, well,
I'm going through
I got
a lot
hit
of...
by a wave 2 months ago in Costa Rica, for real. Okay, and was nearly killed. Again.
In her ear.
Yeah, honestly, I was thrown on rocks.
He has a house in Costa Rica. I'm going to go this summer.
On rocks.
Can I go
this
summer?
I haven't really talked about it in detail on the show yet, but I was thrown on rocks.
That's horrible.
I had to drive myself for 2 hours through the jungle to the hospital, in a tiny little hospital, and then they held me overnight for observation. They wouldn't let me make a phone call.
Were you, like, loopy with your brain?
I was loopy
you
with
hit
my
your
brain.
Head?
I hit my head. I broke two ribs. Was bleeding internally.
Oh!
Oh, yeah, it was a bad scene.
You did almost die, dude.
Yeah, yeah. No,
you're not going to do that again, are you?
I'm not going to get hit by a wave again. Because I grew up in Ottawa, right? So they don't have ocean.
You don't get it.
Yeah.
The ocean can kill.
Yeah. No,
and that's just one of the ways it can kill you.
Yeah.
It can suck you under.
I know, I got sucked out in a riptide the day before. I'm never going near it again. It's ridiculous.
But he has a house on the water.
Yeah, it's ridiculous.
Costa Rica.
So wait.
Baby, come here.
So wait.
She's making a lot of noise. Baby, come
here. Where did the little perch go? Do we have that anywhere?
Yeah.
Let's take some calls here.
Come here.
Hello, Michelle.
Yeah.
Yes, how you doing?
Oh,
there it is. Well, we're doing good. We're doing good. What do you want to talk about
here?
You have a question for Andy
right
Dick.
Here.
Now, come on, people. Give us...
I only have a question.
She will break it.
I want to tell Tom that, hey, your show is awesome, even though you didn't have a guest the other day, you can still do it, man.
Oh, yeah, when I put the laundry basket on my head and sort of ran around and made sort of gurgling sounds for 20 minutes. Yeah.
Yeah, that was pretty funny.
Did you?
Yeah, that's about all we had,
sounds
really.
Like you. Remember that your episode where you just got stuff like this. You just had the can. I know. I saw this in your movie, dude.
Stuff like
he's got a movie coming out that looks hysterical.
Wigs.
I actually got goosebumps. Stop
Wigs.
It with the props.
I'm
not
carrot
top.
You know, come on.
I know,
just telling
I'm not
you.
I'm not using.
We got
them.
Cheetos.
No. Come on, please stop. Please stop.
Okay, all right.
And remember on your show when you brought the camera right into your eye and you just left it there for minutes.
On the
Tom Green Show
MTV. Yeah.
Although that was one that was from Canada,
yeah,
I could tell.
Yeah,
I could always tell the ones that were from Canada
as
opposed to the ones you were doing.
Yeah.
Well,
was,
you could tell the architecture.
It was
background.
Quite a bit
that's
different. We were using like a crappy SVHS camera.
And it's crappy, yeah.
And
the architecture. And they were always a little bit
weirder.
Weirder.
A little bit off center. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Better.
Yeah, it was
better. MTV, they fucking stick their nose up your butt.
Yeah, you know, it's
am I allowed to say fuck?
You can say whatever you want.
That's what I love about your show.
Yeah. But, I mean, you had a good experience with MTV, too, though, right? Did you? Or?
Mm-hmm. Good and bad.
Yeah.
It's up and down. Any relationship is.
Yeah. It's this business is so damn stressful sometimes.
It's a lonely business. You said that earlier to me tonight. It really is a lonely business.
Yeah.
Are you okay, baby?
What's
you know what?
Right?
She's on something. Oh, she's on this DVD.
You know the fun thing about this
we can just basically sit around here.
We don't even have to really.
It's that thing. Look, it's right
there.
We
have no advertisers.
It's
just the cap.
She was balancing.
You just basically sit around, and you know, there's no real stress for you know, like the pacing can be different here. You see.
I'm gonna call Bob's home.
No one's watching anyways, so we can.
Yes, they are.
It's simply an exercise.
LA.
I find this is actually a great way to
go to
practice.
Oklahoma.
It's like a talk show practice. I call it.
Can I use that? Is that the magic wand? Oklahoma. No, down here.
Wait. Okay. Yeah, Jeffrey from Oklahoma. Okay. Jeffrey from Oklahoma. You're on the air.
Well, he's on the phone.
Andy.
He just said hello right into the mic.
Hello,
what's up, buddy?
How's it going?
Great. How are you?
I was wondering if you
Whenever you're growing up, did you have a hard time with the last name Dick?
Well, yes.
Hello?
Cool.
Who's that?
What's going on? Who's that?
Hello?
There's okay. Two people. Right. Oh, somebody picked
the
up the phone.
The phone system's a little nutty.
No, somebody in their
okay,
house
okay, we got
is
a couple
nutty.
Of lines for you right
their
now.
The house is nutty. The sister picked it up on the other line. Hello?
I was on a party line there. Andy, what do you think of Lou Dobbs? You know who that is?
No. Yes, I've heard that name.
Chris from Los Angeles.
Is he?
Hey, Tom.
Is he a sports person?
Hey, what's up?
He's
my
on CNN.
On?
He does a show on CNN.
Oh, I don't care.
Where are all those?
I don't care about any politics or sports.
Yeah, no, we don't
Mr.
really talk
Dick.
About politics
what?
Much here either.
Hey, Mr. Dick.
What?
Have you heard of the new Bob Saget rap video?
What? No. Have you?
Well, check it out.
Yeah, it's the Jamie Kennedy did a video with Bob Saget.
You better act some. What do you mean, Mr. Bob? He was doing Bob Saget.
That's Jamie Kennedy,
right?
He came by the other one. He came by the other day, too.
But everyone's seen this.
Look at this. Has everyone seen this stuff?
They showed that on Letterman.
They did?
How are you with Letterman lately? He's hot and cold, man.
Yeah, he let me host,
let the thing
let me
bite
host
it.
The show once.
Let the
you
thing
believe that? I have a little letter from the man.
Look, there's the shot. Get the sunset. Put this. Have the bird shaking my head, and then cut to the sunset.
What?
and then cut to the sunset.
Hey, you like that?
Look, a tug of war with me and the bird.
You like that, Rex? That's Rex Murphy is the name of the bird.
There you go. Mm-hmm. Rex, I love you.
Playing with the Andy.
Bob's not, he knows it's me.
Who are you calling?
Bob Odenkirk.
Oh,
I'm done calling him.
Okay. Who else you got in there?
Well,
surely.
Don't you want to save?
You're always hanging out with all
don't
these
you
movers
save?
And shakers, right?
Don't you want to save it for later? Let's do one per episode, so I'll come on once a week.
All right, okay.
Well, you know what, though? We have to get a hold of one per episode. That's the thing. We have to get a hold of okay.
I kind of feel like we haven't really done it yet.
Okay,
you know?
Well, let's call
like
Anthony. I'm starting with the A's. I'm going to the A's. I'm calling Anthony Rapp. He's the lead in Rent.
Oh, yeah.
He's great.
He was in Road Trip, right?
Yes, he was.
I've done a scene with him
before.
Oh,
yes.
Yeah.
This is a little triangle.
Acting.
So he might answer.
Hey, Joe from Florida.
Hello?
Anthony.
Hello?
No, I always call when I'm in New York. I know, buddy. I'm on TV, so try to keep it. Actually, you can say anything you want.
That's Joe. That's Joe from Florida. There, I'll turn him off.
You better
call back, Joe.
Call back.
Yeah,
he's never gonna get.
No, he'll call back. He'll get back.
Anthony.
Call back.
I'm doing. I know. He's like, what's happening? I'm doing a TV show. No, it's an internet TV show with Tom Green. Tom Green's the host. It's live all around the world right now.
It's on the national internet. How you doing, man?
I'm fine. How are you, Tom Green?
Good, good. Yeah, long time no talk.
I know.
Yeah, that's cool. I remember hanging out in Athens there. Georgia.
They know each other because they did Road Trip together, and I was in Road Trip as well.
And you guys are friends from way back,
we're
right?
Friends from when I was in high school. He was in
junior high,
and he came in to play Oliver in the high school, and I was in Oliver, and he came in, and then he became a movie star.
Yeah.
He was a
you
movie
can
star.
Google.
He was already, I was fascinated because he had already played Oliver on Broadway, and then he came to play
And he was in Rent as well, right?
Yes, you did.
Rent as well, right?
Wait, I'm getting
a
text.
Rent?
Well, whatever happened. He's been in 9 Broadway shows. That's my point. Yeah. He's the lead in Rent. Anthony.
Hey, Chris.
Anthony Rapp, clap.
To the hands. I asked these guys to be more lively tonight. I haven't heard
Angeles.
A peep out of them all night.
Hey.
Yeah, we better.
Are you in the studio?
We got to get to work here.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm left here alone at the desk for a moment.
It's just me and Tom Green and the camera people and a bird.
Talk to. Hey, don't eat that. Don't eat the microphone.
A big,
it's
beautiful.
A green-winged macaw.
Macaw, which is the one that has all. Yeah. Say it to him. One more time. Oh, he kissed
here.
You.
Rex.
How can you do that? How did you? Did somebody train it?
No, I just, we're friends. See? Hey, baby.
See? How does he, really?
Yeah, we're friends.
You made him, you trained him to do
that?
Yeah,
I kind of did. I'm trying to get her to do one, watch this, that's two, and then one way. No, one. Yeah, no.
Oh.
She sort of gets it. They're pretty smart.
Oh, my God.
They're pretty smart. You're a good little fella. See that? Get a close-up of that, of the head rubbing. See.
That is so
show the people
cute.
On the
it's
world,
like
on the national internet. How?
Ow, is he hurting you?
No, he's just playing with me. Ow! That hurts. Okay.
Did it hurt a little?
A little bit, yeah.
Anthony, anyways, what are you doing now, buddy? I loved Rent. You were great in not only the play, which I saw five times, but the movie. You're awesome. What's going on, though?
Thank you very much.
And we have a caller here with a question for you.
Your movie,
oh, right. Andy's in Danny Rowan.
What's that?
He's in my movie.
Yeah.
All my friends are in it.
Oh, my God.
All the people in my phone are in my movie, except you, because you weren't up in Vancouver. I called him to play the devil.
I know. Wow, that's a bummer.
You know what I did? Cut that part out of the movie.
Yeah.
I cut the part out of the movie because you didn't do it.
Well, I apologize. I really didn't want to. I was honestly up in Saskatchewan.
You would have been hysterical.
Right at the same time.
I know you were. He was shooting his movie, which looks funny. Anthony, I'm sorry to bug you,
buddy.
Figured
you held up production, waited for me, worked around my schedule, but you just went right on with it.
No, we just cut it out.
No, I know.
Buddy, I'm going to be going to LA, I mean to New York soon.
We're just hanging out here with Andy Dick. You can give us a call at 866.
Where are you going to be?
626-4254. He's talking to his
teaching
friend, actor Anthony Rapp, who you may have seen in movies like Road Trip.
Oh, weird.
You're watching Tom Green
that.
Live on
Anyways,
Media TV.
Call me, buddy. I want to catch
here,
up,
ladies
please.
And gentlemen. Having a lot of fun doing this
I've been
show.
Really sad lately.
We are broadcasting on the internet.
Yeah.
Live.
Tom is like my doctor.
Around the world. The time is 8:31.
He actually
Pacific
has
daylight
made me
time.
Feel good. I've been laughing more.
Andy
now
Dick
than I
is here
months.
With us.
But I got to go. I love
and
you, buddy.
We are
bye.
Having a great time tonight.
Okay, bye.
Broadcasting live from my living room here in Los Angeles, California. We have Benji from California on the phone, though, has a question for Andy.
Hi. How are you?
Hi.
You hi?
Fine.
What's your question, Benji?
Are
and why is your name Benji? Benji? Oh, my God. See, you know, there's a few technical problems.
He sounds like you. He's mimicking you. You come in and you go, hi.
I think the other day he said Robert. Robert's running
He's
the
like, huh?
system back.
Robert.
Hi.
Hi.
Yeah, hi. Yeah, we get along. Us too. Hey,
how long have you had him?
Like about 6 months only. Yeah.
That's it?
Yeah, and we're just kind of getting on like gangbusters here. You know, she's only 16 months old. So.
And you really did teach her that thing?
Yeah, I taught her that thing.
They are so smart.
Yeah, she's good. She's good. And if you give her, watch this. If I give her, a potato chip, she'll say...
If you hold your hand, if you talk, what she say? Because she does it as long as you do. If you keep him up there, will she keep him up there?
I'm not really sure. Let's see here. No, come on.
It probably hurts. No. Oh my God! Yeah, that's great.
Yeah, yeah.
I want a potato chip. Watch what I do.
Yeah. She'll actually. She'll say. Watch this. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Watch. Alright. Watch this. Say wait. Say wait. There you go. Alright. Alright. Cool. Okay. Wait. Jason from Toronto, you have a question for Andy.
Take this away from me. I'm trying to lose my beer belt.
Jason from Toronto, you have a question for Andy Dick.
Yes, I do.
Yes.
I'm a huge news radio fan, and I saw the episode where he beat Joe Rogan in a fight by tickling him. Now, could Andy Dick really beat him? Because he's looking kind of buff now.
Now? He was buff back then. That guy was... what's that called?
Ultimate Fighting Champion?
He was an Ultimate Fighting Champion.
Yeah.
I think you could probably take him.
What did you say?
I don't know. What did you say there, sir?
He thinks you could take him.
Oh, yeah.
No.
No, that guy.
Oh, I look buff?
Yeah, you look buff, man.
Jason, what is the point of your call?
That's it. I wonder if he could beat Joe Rogan in a fight now.
Okay, all right. Not really.
Hey, what's up? What's up, Joe?
I think
Joe Rogan.
I think Joe Rogan is...
You want a piece of this, Joe fucking Rogan? Come on and get it!
Is this Andy Dick?
That's Andy Dick, sir, yes. Ask your question.
Oh, my God, I'm totally obsessed with your old show on MTV. I'm wondering if there could be any possibility of a Zitty McGee spinoff.
Dude, that's weird that you say that, because I was just thinking... Tell me, I want your honest opinion about this. I was just thinking about doing a fucking Zitty McGee movie. They do anything.
Oh my God.
Wouldn't that be great?
Yeah.
You know that character?
I'll do it right now.
Me, my family, all of us, obsessed with Z. It's like bordering on some sort of psychotic disorder. We need the Zitty. Do it. Definitely do it.
I'm going to do it.
It's like a. There's
what was the character Zitty
McGee? I'm going to talk to you about Zitty. Seriously.
I'm going to do it then. Ziggy McGee had tons of zits.
Oh, yeah, I know Ziggy McGee, yeah.
But he was a model. He was trying to be a model.
Yeah. Why don't you do a whole movie of Ziggy McGee?
Yeah. What else do
People
I have?
People like zits.
I'm also going to do a movie of Daphne.
That would be funny, because you know what? I thought, you know, those guys in the beginning of that White Chicks movie, you know, the two guys, the convenience store owners?
Is it the
Wayans
Squarbo?
Brothers
movie?
The Wayans. Yeah. They do this funny character, too. I thought they should do a whole movie of that. You know those guys?
Hey, Andy. Andy, are you still there? I have one more question about Little Brown Ring. Is there any way I can see you perform Little Brown Ring live?
No, okay. I don't know. So, I mean, the little guy, all freaking out, the effects.
How did they
It's like
that?
A mini-me, but they converted a real guy into a
That's
mini-me.
That's horrible for the little people out there.
I don't know, it's just...
He took away from the job of a little person. That would be like a little person doing a movie.
No, I think... Because
he's such a great actor but they want him to be normal, that they put his head on
to
a normal...
We're talking about the movie Little... What's it called?
But I'm saying...
Little Me.
It would be offensive... If they took a midget's head and put it on your body.
Right.
Because he's such a great actor, but they want him to be normal looking.
Well, that could probably happen in my case, I think, you know. I'm sure somebody would think of doing that, maybe, just to sort of cover some shots or whatever.
I'm so mean to the guest.
Hello, Horst.
Hello.
Is this Horst? Who is this?
This is Horst.
Okay.
I had to go grab a Canadian beer from the fridge. I gave the phone to my sister very quickly.
Oh, okay.
Oh, cool.
Okay.
Jesus,
they're passing the phone around.
Is there a way I could see Andy Dick performing live?
Have you seen it?
Have I seen what?
Me performing live, because I've done a lot of shows in Canada.
No, I'm up in Seattle.
I've done shows in Seattle, so you haven't seen them?
No, I haven't.
Yeah,
Are you going to be up here soon?
No, I'm not going to be anywhere soon, buddy. But listen, this guy would be one of the ones that stuck around for the whole show and would love it.
Yeah. What shot is that? What camera is that?
I'm talking to you here. My sister has a question. Please talk to her.
That one? That's your single there, okay?
Oh, I keep looking
at it. Yeah, I know. Oh, we have no tally lights.
We're getting tally lights next week. I loved you in Bongwater, too. That movie was awesome.
Put a little piece of tape on Andy's single, so.
I keep looking at that.
We have no tally lights.
He has one.
And my brother's got a Hebrew Hammer DVD.
Wait, who's talking here? There's too many people talking at once. I know it's fun to hear.
I need help.
I'm hanging up on these people. Give us a call here at 866-626-4254.
Oh, he's hanging a bag of Doritos on my camera.
Because
he knows that's going to kill
me. We love Doritos. Yeah.
We do love
Doritos. Give us a call. We could take some advertising money around here. Doritos. Delicious. No, but it's fun. We have five cameras. They're all hooked up to the we're in my living room here. This is... my living room here in Los Angeles, and we're taking calls. And the phones are lighting up like crazy.
Well, look, now
it's been an exciting week, actually.
Massachusetts, Maryland, Texas, Michigan.
Yeah.
Maryland. He picked Maryland.
Cameron from Maryland. I'm just going down
in
order.
A couple more chips.
I'm going in order.
Hey, guys.
Two more chips.
Andy, what is the highlight of your career?
I don't want any. What did he say?
What is the highlight of your career for you?
Then put them under the table so I can't say it.
That was great. See, come on. There's a somebody edit that out and send it to these people. You know? Give us some money here, okay? This is bleeding me dry here, this internet thing, you know? It's fun and everything. We're having a good time. You know, I'm getting to what's fun is I'm getting to hang out with you, you know, this is cool.
You keep fishing. You keep throwing the line out. Someone's going to bite. I don't know if it's Dorito. You know, you're putting all the chip companies against each.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I know. Well, I mean,
you should spread out with like Go-Gurt.
Like, I don't care who it is. We'll take Cheetos money. We'll take kettle chips money.
You're only
going
for the chips. What about soups?
Soups. Can we get a camera in the kitchen?
Oh, I know why you're going for the chips, because everyone who's watching is high.
No, I don't care.
They have the munchies. Oh,
yeah.
Some of those people make soup.
Absolutely.
Some of those people make like Campbell's chunky chicken soup.
Ravioli. Chef Boyardee ravioli.
Chef Boyardee. Give him
a call.
Can
we get a camera in the kitchen here? Let's go. We want to go examine some of the advertising potential.
Let's go see what he has.
Yeah, give him a second here. Let's take a couple calls.
Yes. Watch this.
Give him just a second here. Are you ready to go? Okay, let's go. Let's go have a look over here.
He's going to go. Watch.
Bill, here's Heidi from Michigan. We're going to put on the air while we go over to the kitchen. Hi. Come on, Rex. Come on over here. This is the kitchen over here.
Oh, it's so good.
Heidi, you're on the air.
Hi, Andy Dick. This is Heidi. I was wondering what you would be doing if you weren't in show business.
What would you be doing if you weren't in show business?
Honestly, it was either going to be show business or something with animals. That's really? Why I'm so fascinated with the macaw. I wanted a macaw at first when I wanted... Then now I want an African gray. What is it?
Really? You really would have been working with animals?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. I would have went to school to be like a biologist of some sort.
Really? That's awesome. Yeah, I love animals, man.
Eons. We love animals.
Check this out. Check this out.
Tom Green loves animals.
Yeah. And what else? Well, I was on PETA's worst
Eons
offender
for
list
your wolves.
Twice in 1 year.
Wolves what else only did I like here? Eons.
If Heidi, are you still there?
If a wolf can't get a rabbit or a small cat or a small bird, then its second choice
what
is
eons. What would you
eons
do with animals? That doesn't really pay very much.
That's the commercial.
We just, see, there's a commercial for Eons dog food.
But it's wolf food.
Kraft mayo.
We love it. That's so horrible.
You don't like that stuff?
Well, don't say that. That's not going to help.
I like it.
There, that'll help.
I like it. It might not help.
Hey, they've got the best advertising. Let's come up with one right now.
Yeah, Corona.
You know, like Change Your Latitude or Gridlock with the lemon stuck in there. They've got the best. Let's come up with one now.
Okay, yeah.
How about, Tom, can you pull this out of my butt? I'm thirsty.
No, that's not going to.
Can you pull this out of my butt?
That's not going to sell beer. That's not going to sell beer.
Okay, hang on. How about...
Heidi.
How about this? Ready?
Yeah.
Here's the ad. It's just me and you, and either you.
Yeah,
or
but don't
I'm
hurt yourself.
This. I'm not. We're not going to do anything. It's a print ad.
It seems like a print ad.
There's just one line here, and it's just you or me either saying, "I'll race you for it, to it. I'll race you to it."
Okay. Well, let me
rewriting.
Let me put the bird over here.
Yeah, the bird.
Let's get
distracts
over here. I don't want to kill the bird in the process.
No, that was it. No, we weren't going to race to it. That's it. It's a print ad.
It's looking at itself in the mirror, and it's just talking to itself.
We're not doing it anymore. It is.
Yeah. I'm going to have a beer myself. Actually.
You are.
I don't drink. I know you don't. I'm not going to offer you
one.
Would you like some water or something?
I have one. I like this doctor.
Yeah.
You're the best doctor, honestly. My therapist, I don't think he would let me drink.
Okay.
Here's to my new therapist.
I don't want to be a bad influence. So.
No, you're a good influence.
Yeah, come on. Let's go back
Dr.
here.
Green.
Let's go back
Dr. Green's going to cure Dr. Dick.
Let's go back here and talk about some of the real problems that you're
the
experiencing.
The bird laughed. You like that one. Dr. Dick.
Oh, wait. I can't leave.
Dr. Dick.
I almost left the bird out here.
He didn't like it the second time.
Come on, Rex. Come on.
Dr. Tick.
He doesn't think it's funny anymore.
Hello, you're watching the World Wide Web, the national
internet
right now.
I'm going to go to the bathroom.
Right, okay, Andy Dick is here. We're live from TomGreen.com, the channel, broadcasting on Mania TV around the world, having a wonderful time here tonight. A wonderful, wonderful, wonderful time. Come on, follow me back as we go back into the set area here. My house here in Los Angeles, California. We are taking your calls from around the world. Please give us a call at 1-866-626-4254. You're watching Tom Green live on the national internet.
They can probably hear me pissing. And.
Oh, yeah, we can hear you, Andy.
Damn it.
Andy, we can hear you in there.
I should have sung a song or something.
Yeah, you can hear that in there. Heidi, thanks for calling.
I only have one beer.
Bill from Massachusetts, you're on the air.
What?
Parrots have loose assholes.
What's the question, sir?
Do
parrots have loose assholes?
Like I went into the bathroom and fucked it just now? Is that what you're insinuating?
What exactly are you insinuating, sir?
I need somebody to find out.
Bill, what are you insinuating here?
I want a good pet.
Let's hang up on that.
He wants what?
I don't know. It was something.
He wants a good pet.
Yeah, he wants a good, okay. Alyssa,
he wants a good pet.
Alyssa
good
from Texas is age 15 years old, and she wants to know what kind of girls that Andy likes. Alyssa?
Hey.
Hey, how you doing?
Yeah,
you're on the air with Andy Dick.
I keep
Dick
looking over there because the speaker's
Hi,
over there.
Hi, Andy Dick. This is Alyssa.
How are you? You sound so nice.
She just sounds nice.
So what type of girls are you
sounds
into?
Sounds like a nice person.
I'm sorry?
What type of girls are you into?
Just beautiful from the inside out.
That sounds so sweet.
But I like younger girls, the older girls, because I'm young at heart. I feel like I'm probably
15?
No.
A little bit.
Please.
Alyssa.
You're cute. You're my son's age. No, I have an 18-year-old, by the way.
You do, really?
Yeah.
Wow.
18-year-old son.
Oh, my gosh, yeah. So, you guys hang out?
Yeah, he lives with me now.
Oh, yeah? Oh, that's cool. What's that like?
You know what? This is part of my now we're getting to some juicy issues.
Yeah.
Excuse me.
Thanks, Alyssa, for calling.
I supported my ex and my son and was there as much as I could be. And we spend a lot of time together. We all love each other.
Yeah.
We don't live together.
Didn't you live
we're
with
exes. I had my son when I was like 22. Let's not get into that.
Okay.
My point is right now, let's fast forward.
I read that here.
Let's get into it. Yeah, you know, yeah. My point is that, 18 years of me financially supporting them mm-hmm. and being there as much as I can. Mm-hmm. And then right when he turns 18, she's gone off to Japan to teach English and he just moves in with me.
Yeah.
And now I've got him full time.
But that sounds like that might be kind of fun, though.
We're having a good time.
Yeah, you can probably.
At first, I was frightened, and I was like, "What?" And then, but it's secretly not excited, and we're having fun. But
we can't
let the ex know.
What's he
that.
Do? Oh, you can't. Well, you
know,
just said
he know what he's doing right this second.
National internet.
She's not gonna tune in.
No, she won't watch.
She could though. She's in Osaka.
Yeah, really?
Osaka, Japan. I want a call from Osaka.
Yeah,
get it to me.
But listen. Yeah.
She, one sip of beer, and I'm like, loony.
Yeah, no, it's, you know.
No wonder. I can't drink. I mean,
you like a Coca-Cola
out.
Or a glass of water?
No,
something?
I haven't.
Cup
beer.
Of coffee?
I like the beer.
All right.
But the thing is he's right now taking his first improv class at Improv Olympic, where
right.
I studied. It's
right.
called the IO out here. I studied in Chicago.
Okay.
I actually have.
So you were.
He's taking classes in the Andy Dick Experimental Black Box Theater / Gallery.
Really?
They named a little
Where's
corner.
Where's this, here in L.A.?
Yeah, they named a little corner after me. They really did.
Oh, that's cool.
And he's taking classes in that space right now as we speak.
No, wait, do you get up on stage a lot? And
I had to wake him up, though. He took a nap, and I'm like, get up. I'm going to do Tom Green. You go do your class.
Yeah.
It's his first class.
Well, you should
he
bring,
wanted to.
You
he
should bring him
me.
Here next time you come here. Mm-hmm. Bring him by.
Okay.
Meet the
you
guy.
Would love it.
Yeah, yeah.
He's awesome.
Yeah,
and he'll
cool.
tell you, you'll... You're gonna embarrass me, but I don't.
We
got to
have
I've
him on the show.
To
I think
got
we got to have him and you
go
on the
ahead.
Show at the same
care.
Time. And we do maybe we do a little improv Olympics as well. We could do.
You can you? Can
I don't.
You?
I don't know. I could probably try.
Let's try. We'll teach
yeah.
you a
yeah,
game.
I could probably try.
You know, we'll teach you one of the games
yeah.
that he knows because
yeah.
I know them all.
Yeah,
and
absolutely.
Then we'll play
I
a game.
Can,
I love
I can
that idea.
Make funny faces or whatever. Do some
no.
goofy.
No.
No. No. What do you mean?
I'll
jump up and down like a nincompoop or whatever they do. Hey, Shane from Boston, you're on the air.
You're a nincompoop. Yes.
We're having a good time. We're having as good a time as we were 1 minute ago when we were asked the exact same question for the 30th time tonight. Thanks for asking again, Shane.
I have a question.
Yeah, what is it?
Andy, who does your hair?
Who does your hair?
Well, they dyed it for the movie Employee of the Month, that movie with Jessica Simpson. And then I let it go gray again. I have blonde and gray hair.
Yeah, no, I noticed.
And
wait,
then,
so you were did a movie. You shot, where did you shot that? New Mexico?
Yeah, Santa Fe.
With Dane Cook?
Yeah, and your friend Dax.
And Dax
Well,
Shepherd.
No, he's not your friend anymore.
Well,
you're acquaintance.
I don't know him well.
Right.
You had
I don't know. Who,
you
no,
had a
I
bit of, you did you have a blowout on set with him, right? you brought it up.
I didn't bring it up on camera. You just...
No, I'm okay. Well, you brought
no,
it up.
It's
but you
fine.
Were making it look like I had a problem with the guy. I like the guy. I do. I think he's a funny
well,
guy.
Well, no, I hate both
I want him to come on the
I
show.
I hate both of you.
Yeah, no, come on.
I'm just
messing around.
No, no, and
no,
I don't hate
you
him.
Know, look, it gets,
I actually, I love him.
I,
and we
he's
made
a
up.
Really funny guy. It gets
he
stressful on set.
It gets stressful.
Certain have people have different ways of working. You're a bit more of an improviser. He wanted to do it sort of by the script.
Yeah,
and there's
there
a little thing that happened.
Yeah.
That's all. No big deal. But we should get him to come by the show, and we could all talk about it together. I think it would be cool.
This is a painting by my friend Will Sasso. Oh, if he comes to the set, invite me. I would love to come.
Dax.
Because we're friends. Yeah.
Yeah
we
yeah.
really are friends.
No,
we made up.
Because I think when everyone's sitting around, it's cool. Like, you know, maybe, you know, like, you know, we could have a few people. You know, like, I met Merv Griffin the other day.
Tell me about that. Yeah. You told me
it was the most
camera,
awesome thing.
I,
and I
we
talked
didn't
to him
get
for a second. And
well, why did you meet him?
Because
like,
we were
was
doing
the
that HBO pilot, and I wrote him a letter because I wanted to talk to him about this thing we're doing. I wanted to get some advice about this
and
thing.
And he, like,
so I wrote him.
Yes.
I wrote him a nice letter, and I told him about.
And he said, "Come on to the studio.
Said,
bring your cameras."
He said, "Pop by the office."
And he let you film him.
And he let us. I interviewed him and talked to him for. I wouldn't say it was an interview. We had a
but
conversation.
But was it like an hour?
About 40 minutes. Yeah.
No.
Yeah, I think I may have overstayed my welcome.
But you're gonna have some good footage,
yeah.
dude.
Yeah.
No, you did.
Yeah.
You did.
No,
you went
cool.
a little long.
No, no,
but you need to because now you can edit something.
He
real
was funny.
Juicy.
He was funny. He was getting in arguments with the cameraman and stuff. Which
he
was,
was.
Good stuff.
That's the stuff you're gonna use.
No,
dude.
He's still got it, man. He's funny,
oh,
funny guy.
Funny.
Awesome.
You're funny.
Yeah. So Samantha.
That's funny, dude. That's going to be funny.
Samantha, you have a question.
Can I have another chip?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, what's your question?
I was wondering if Andy Dick's sons are hot.
Yeah, that's the thing. Well, that's one of the reasons I don't want to bring him on. He's a stud.
Yeah.
He's like 6'1" or 6'2".
And
he's bigger. And he's like, what's up, Dad? Well, Tom Green, yeah, I love that guy. Let's go. You know, you'll see. And yeah. He looks.
But that's
he's
cool, though.
Slob. His mom's 100% Polish.
Yeah.
So he's got these Slavic, I don't know what it's called over there.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Sort of Nordic.
Nordic, features. I guess. Yeah. It's yeah. like very.
Cheekbones
like,
and.
Yeah.
Kind of looks like that guy
in the Rocky movie.
The guy in the Rocky movie.
He looks
or
like.
Whatever his name was.
Michelangelo.
Yeah, was his really, name Dolph no, Lundgren? Does he look like Dolph?
He looks like Dolphin. Michelangelo.
Oh, that's awesome. Okay, Jesse from New York.
Michelangelo's David.
Oh, okay, yeah.
The sculpture that Michelangelo did of David.
Sure, not the thinker.
No.
Hey. Good girl, though. Why are you?
Yeah, you keep asking for him. Hey, Jesse from New York.
Hey, what's up, Andy?
What's up?
Yeah, I was wondering if you have any types of, like, TV shows planned out for the future.
Yeah.
Three
of them.
What are they about?
Four. I just shot Jessica Simpson's new music video.
So what's she like?
Sweet, down home country girl.
Yeah.
Really sweet. Like
really.
The sweetest. She's just the sweetest.
For real.
For real.
Really?
Doesn't get any sweeter.
Really?
Really?
Really not caught up in herself, running around, going crazy, going
nuts.
Oh,
no. It almost seems like she doesn't want this.
Oh, yeah?
Uh-huh.
Wow.
She's awesome.
Because that was just sort of an explosion all of a sudden, you know? Well,
and she's tortured. And she's sad.
No, really?
Well, she was married, and it was all good, and they had a show. Newlyweds!
Yeah. But I mean, I think people
got
Newlyweds! But they got to expect
old
when you do that, that's going to be the logical
ending. Right when the show's over, divorced?
Yeah,
that's American.
You can't really
nowadays.
Let cameras in the house through that door in a private relationship.
I think that's what kept it going.
Yeah.
I heard that they said we're getting a separation. Then they said, no, here's a bunch of money.
Yeah.
Stay together for a couple more seasons.
Well, that's rough. Well, you know,
I heard that. I don't know if that's true.
Well, it'd probably be pretty easy to do with Jessica Simpson, you know.
But listen,
Couldn't have paid me enough money, but...
I can't call her.
Yeah,
but she is the best woman ever. She really is sweet. But listen, so I have that.
Yeah.
Okay, I have to answer this question.
Okay, yeah, Jessica.
I have that coming out any second. And then right after that, I've got Employee of the Month with her. But the song isn't related to the movie.
Kelly from Florida.
No, and then I also have...
When's the Comedy Central special?
We're going. We're developing it.
Okay, good. Okay,
and you're going to be on it.
I will absolutely.
Because
I would love to be on it.
It's like a roast, but it's thinly disguised as a roast.
Uh-huh.
It's a roast really, but it's thinly disguised as a surprise 40th. Birth, and I'm already 40, that's part of the joke I'm going to have to do.
Right.
Like, I already have, I'm almost 41, guys, you know, but whatever,
like
TV doesn't matter.
Like a scripted sitcom type comedy?
Yeah, but a lot of improv. So, you know, you just come on and we go, here's the gist, and we just improvise.
Yeah.
So it's going to be improv. And then it's going to be, but then it's going to be,
like
a
Curb
this
Your
is
Enthusiasm
your
kind of style of shooting?
No,
or?
Much more improvised.
Yeah.
And then it's going to be, I'm not going to know things, I'm not going to know anything.
Yeah.
It's going to be a This Is Your Life, remember that show?
We were just
watching Jack Parr in his guest house, in his like pool house.
Yeah, this
he's got this really, he's got a fucking rocking house.
This guy
here, Jack Parr.
This guy was awesome. Look him up on the internet.
We were just watching Bette Davis. It was Bette Davis and Jonathan Winters. We were watching the episode with
you. I got to show you the rest of that Jonathan Winters.
Well, I want to come over and just start hanging out, man, because we have the same likes and dislikes.
Andy
I
Dick
like
is going
the color.
To be here all the time. He's
once
claiming.
A week,
he's
not
claiming.
All the time. Once a week.
Once a week is all the time.
Yeah,
that's a
I
lot.
Don't even remember what we were talking about. It was something.
Let's take
what was it?
More
what
calls.
Was it?
We were talking about your 18-year-old son. We were talking about.
I had a point.
Officer Matt David from...
What was I talking about?
Jessica Simpson.
The what?
Oh,
Jessica Simpson.
We have a member of our military on the line here.
You know what? I don't... You
from,
just have to tune in. It's going to be like This Is Your Life. Remember in the 50s?
Okay.
Who's this voice?
Listen to this.
Who's this voice?
Let's talk to this man. I met this man in Bahrain, actually.
Drink your beer.
Funnily enough, there's a picture of me here in Bahrain, right here in our studio. How's it going, sir?
How you doing, sir? Outstanding.
turn to
my question to the both of you is, are you going to be doing any more USO tours anytime soon? Because I'm
I'll
actually
go.
Going to be deployed here soon again, and I did get to see you in Bahrain for about 20 seconds because I had other stuff I had to do, it was great that you guys support us and come out there like that.
Yeah, you know what, that was a real...
did you drink beer in Bahrain?
I did drink beer in Bahrain, yeah, and
you
I drank.
Did.
We went to Djibouti, Africa. And we're actually, funnily enough, we have a picture right here, sir. This is Officer Matt David. Where are you right now?
I'm at Virginia Beach, Virginia, and I'm Oceana, the Master Jet Base.
I lived in Virginia Beach. I lived in 9 different places. I lived in Virginia Beach. My dad was a lieutenant commander on a submarine. Are you in the Navy?
Yes, sir, I am.
Virginia Beach.
I actually got a deputy blog up there where I've got a few videos where...
Oh, yeah. Oh, we'll go check that out. That's on...
Stuff like that, but... Yep. Yeah, come to Virginia Beach. We'll go flying.
Okay, cool. Well, thanks,
flying.
Matt.
Flying? Flying in on a boat. What did we say? Well, I said Navy. Is he in the Air Force?
Well, you know, the Navy, they have the jets, right? Remember Top Gun? Top Gun was a Navy pilot.
Exactly.
Right?
You have one of those aircraft carriers, and then we're going to go up in a plane? I'm not going. I wouldn't do that.
We should do that. Yeah, we should do a USO tour. We should go together
and
go.
Crash and die, right?
What did he say?
What's that, sir?
I said the worst thing that we could possibly happen when you go up in a plane is we all crash and die. So
yeah, exactly.
If you think of it that way, it's really not all that bad.
Yeah, it would be over before we knew it, right? Okay. Well, yeah, thanks. Thanks, Matt. Well, we'll try to do that then someday.
All right, Tyler, I appreciate it. Thanks for calling. Taking my call.
Cheers, thanks.
I'm not doctor. Doctor, before you take off.
Yes, sir.
I'm not suicidal.
Well, thank heavens.
But I sometimes, if I'm on a plane, sometime or something or you know like that I don't have control over.
Right.
I think, you know what, if this plane goes down, thank you.
Absolutely. I know what you're
saying. I sometimes have that feeling. That is a form of suicidal.
No, it's being fatalistic.
I'm sometimes fatalistic, but not always. Like right now, I'm feeling great lately.
Yeah.
You know, my kids are living with me. All of them, by the way. That's another part of the thing I want to talk to you about.
Right.
My 18-year-old lives with me for the rest of his life.
Yeah. How so? He's going to live.
Until he gets, you know, a job and buys a house.
That won't be
something.
The rest of his life. That'll be maybe
right.
A few more years.
It feels right now like the rest of his life.
Yeah, sure. But
yes,
it won't
thank
be,
you.
Obviously, he's not.
You know what?
Look, he's not going to want.
My time is well spent if I can just let that sink in.
Yeah, no, trust
I'm serious because it feels like the rest of my life.
Yeah, no, I am sure he will want to get out of there at some point. Probably sooner than you think. I would think. I'm just kidding. I'm fucking around.
So that's why it's the only doctor of crazy.
No.
They call him Dr. Crazy with the K.
Like, it's going to be over before you know it. This life goes by so quickly. I mean, isn't time flying
dragon.
By quickly
He is
now?
The grand dragon.
Isn't time just flying by quickly?
He's the grand dragon of the San Fernando Valley
no.
chapter
no,
of the KKK.
Absolutely not true.
I saw the sheets in his closet.
Yeah, no.
Okay, were those just sheets?
Yeah. They were just sheets. Yeah,
oh,
I just keep sheets.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Then I guess I made.
I'm gonna have to stop wearing these white
I'm
shirts,
sorry.
Though. This
yeah.
is
Patrick. Well, that's my mistake.
Patrick from Florida.
Sorry about that.
Hey, what's going on, guys?
What's up?
My question to Andy is: of all the shows that you've been on over the past few years, which one has been your favorite to work on, and which one have you hated the most?
Oh, that's a good question. He's asking me to be very revealing.
Yeah.
And few is not the right word. It's not the right number for the amount of shows I've done. A few would be 3. I've done
around 10 shows.
I believe
a few is more than 2.
Well, whatever. I've done a bunch. I would say a bunch.
Yeah.
Of all the tons, not a ton. It hasn't been a ton.
What was the first show?
The first show that I did a guest spot on was a show called... with Richard Lewis and Jamie Lee. Anything but love with Richard Lewis and Jamie Lee Curtis.
It was a movie or a television
show?
So
guest spot. Then I did one on Flying Blind with Taya Leone.
Okay. And what? You just moved here to Los Angeles?
Uh huh. Another
Illinois?
Guest spot. But then my first big break, I was 25 years old and I got the Ben Stiller show. That's what really kind of busted open. Everything for
how
me.
How did that happen? You came here to Los
I was doing
Angeles.
A lot of live performances.
How long had you been in L.A. for before you got the Ben Stiller show?
2 or 3 years.
Yeah. And
3 years.
And yet you've been doing comedy?
Yeah, live. I was doing the Improv Olympic, and I was doing Second City, and I was doing a lot of... I was going up on stage singly, but using my improv training to go up and bounce off the audience, because there's no one to improv with.
yeah.
on stage if you're alone. So I learned and used my, I utilized everything I learned to bounce off the audience.
Right.
And I still do that. And it doesn't always go well. That was my point earlier.
Right, right, right.
You know,
right.
I just still bounce off the audience. But a lot of times if I, it had to do with, I was just drunk on stage.
Really? Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
And then the
oh.
show's funny to me.
Yeah.
Because I'm drunk as hell, but the audience, they don't like
yeah.
it.
I did that once as a bit on the, got drunk on purpose
yeah,
on the show.
Yeah, with the Indian family.
Yeah, yeah. And it,
with the Indian
I, you
family,
always,
you were throwing their furniture. See?
Yeah, you always
I'm
end up
I'm a big
being,
fan of Tom Green, yeah, buddy.
It's always
You're trying
yeah,
to test me?
No, it wasn't a test.
You were trying
just,
to test
just
me?
Just trying to say I know what
I've
you're saying.
I've seen everything you've done.
Just
so
saying, I know
don't
what you're
worry
saying.
About that. I told you earlier backstage.
I'm not fishing.
There's no backstage. Backstage is his pool house.
Keep talking.
Or his bedroom.
Yeah.
I hope we go back there later.
Won't be happening.
I'm just kidding.
Will not be happening.
Come on, I'm just kidding. I always
I just want to make sure everyone's
card.
Completely
it
aware.
It won't be happening. I don't want it to happen.
Yeah, no, I know.
I was making a joke.
Look, I'm glad you don't want it to happen.
I was making
happen.
A joke,
frankly,
but I was saying that that I brought up when you brought up the dead raccoon on the...
No, and Mike Bullard show in Canada.
Yeah, I saw that. I don't know how because I don't live in Canada.
Yeah, maybe we aired it once on our television show down here or something.
Oh yeah, you might have.
Yeah.
And it was.
So wait,
half
what
dead.
Do you do? You have a website? Are you like
AndyDick.com?
Yeah. And what do you put on there?
You know what's on there right now?
Yeah.
If you go to AndyDick.com, you'll see the trailer for my movie.
Open
that
up a new window, okay? And then don't leave us.
That is
okay.
weird. They really can, and
yeah.
you can actually see all of the Andy Dick show.
Yeah.
I put it up there illegally.
Yeah, just open up a new window right now, watch us, and go look at Andy's website.
I spent $10,000 of my own money so that you can watch it illegally.
Yeah.
And I shouldn't say that because then I acknowledge that I know it's illegal. Because my whole backup plan was, I didn't know.
This is the Wild West, man.
I didn't know.
This is the internet.
But now they're going to say, oh, you didn't know? Watch this.
Yeah.
Going, I put it up illegally.
Exhibit A. Exhibit A, yeah. No, we probably shouldn't be talking about this.
Can they record this off the internet?
I believe so, yeah. I believe it's just going to be floating around in cyberspace for all eternity.
God.
You know?
It is.
When you really think about it.
It's going on YouTube and all that. Have you been on YouTube?
I think people take clips of this stuff and they post it on YouTube. So it's going to...
Are you fucking serious?
Absolutely, yeah. People can just somehow, some of these people out there are essentially geniuses.
I gotta leave. What is this?
That's Neil Hanton. Then they can post this on YouTube.
The show must go off.
and go to MyTV and on Mania TV and get a MyTV channel. And post it in there. What's this? This is Neil Hamburgers. You okay? You want some water?
The show must go off.
Have you seen him? Do you know him?
He's so creepy.
Yeah.
You said he was on the show.
Yeah.
Can you bring him on next time?
Absolutely. Yeah.
But
okay,
I might actually have
right
a cardiac arrest.
Yeah.
If I saw him live and he said any one of his stupid fucking things.
Yeah.
I think I would shit my pants.
Last night we had Brooke here.
Last night.
Brooke was here. Brooke Shields was here, and Neil Hamburger.
You got Brooke Shields and Neil Hamburger
at the same time, and it was quite the contrast.
Well, he was over there on that chair. What is that?
He was standing actually.
Well, what is that for? Because I could have brought a fucking friend.
Yeah,
I could have brought my son.
That's why I set it up in case you brought someone. You were welcome to bring somebody.
Yeah. No one said that. No. I could have brought five people.
Oh, I figured you know. Well,
I always have an entourage. You were going to put someone up there, the most colorful one.
Yeah, no, I figured if you brought someone, they'd probably be fun to set over there. But you know, it's cool. You having fun here? Is this a good time?
I love this, dude. I wish I would have brought somebody. I'm sad.
Well, you know, just come.
I could have brought a million people.
Come next week.
The weird thing is that I've been alone a lot lately.
Yeah.
But I'm learning to be okay with that.
Yeah.
I really am.
You know what I find helps? Dogs and remembering to put music on in the house.
Remembering to put music.
You remember to put music on in the house.
That's true. It helps.
Music
helps.
Yeah.
And
happy,
I don't want
happy music.
Yeah,
though.
It has to be happy.
Positive.
Yeah, like hey. I'm walking on sunshine. Dun, 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 dun. Ooh.
Yeah, absolutely.
I'm walking on sunshine.
Not that
fun. Woo, woo, woo. You don't like
it
to change
like
on the way.
It's
bound to feel good. Dun, 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 dun.
Yeah,
or it's starting to feel good, whatever the fuck
it
says.
No, I should get a drum set here or something.
Can you play? You can play the drums.
A little bit, yeah.
A little bit.
You
can rap.
A little bit. Not too well, but a little bit. I enjoy doing it. I have fun doing it.
Wait, you didn't answer my question. Was Will Sasso... Was Will Sasso?
Oh, look
guest?
At that! That's a picture of you right there.
I know.
Yeah.
He painted. We were told to make a painting for a charity. Well, I guess mine didn't sell.
No, no. But, this was bought Richard from Mania TV. This our the organization.
Oh, really?
Bought this for me as a.
Oh, then it did sell. That's what I was asking if Will Sasso was a guest. I thought it didn't sell,
no,
and he had,
no,
and they,
no,
they gave
not,
it back to
that's
him.
That's not what happened.
Oh, how much did this go for?
I think about $4 or $5. No, no, I have no idea what it was. It was like it was more than that, I'm sure.
How much? Where is he?
It must have been something substantial. I mean, they would
couple grand.
Well, I don't think
this
that
is
much,
an original Will Sasso painting of me, yeah. Auntie Dick. And yeah. we had to paint something from Less Than Perfect for a charity. I painted dots. I just made dots.
Yeah.
But they're pretty.
Yo, you were part and did this charity too then.
Yeah, we all did. Every cast member painted something. And then he's like, look what I painted. And I'm like, is that fucking me?
Oh, it looks like you. It does.
Well, it is me. So, yes. I guess my fucking nose is crooked. Right, guess my nose.
So here's the deal, Andy.
Zoom in on it real close.
Here's the deal. See?
Zoom all the way. Zoom right the fuck up my nose. All the way. I don't even see my hands. I wanted to fit. Oh!
Why?
Stop. Here. No, not that. No, not go about.
You want to take over for a second?
Hi, I'm here. Shit, where are you going?
I'm just going to go get a glass of water.
Hurry up.
Yeah, yeah. But you just take over for a second. I want you to just go nuts, okay?
No, what? Was I going nuts? Is that
yeah, it was good, and I liked
not
it.
Not leaving.
I want to let you just go nuts for a second. I want you to take over
where
the studio.
Where are you
studio.
Going?
I'm just
going
to stand over here.
Oh,
I'm
going
to stand right here and watch. I'm just going to sit
where's
right
where's Pembroke?
I'll sit
Halifax.
Right here.
Halifax. Do we press the air? There we go.
Can you give me a vodka?
Alistair from Halifax.
Wait, Andy, I just found out
how much the painting cost.
How much?
$500.
Well, that, you know what? That's good. It's not 200.
Yeah.
But it's not 20,000.
Yeah.
It's somewhere way below
that's
below the middle. It's at the lower end.
No, but I mean, come on. That's quite substantial.
500 is good.
Yeah.
He really wanted it.
So this is where somebody could have sat here. See, someone could have sat here.
Yeah. You should show the paintings behind him. They're hysterical. Where's he going?
I thought you were going to go nuts and start
Halifax.
I want you to start doing something.
Hello, are you on the air?
You know when you do the jumping around and the dancing and stuff?
He's right here. No, I don't want to.
Come on. What about some dancing?
Give me some chips.
Come on.
I might do a little
some
dance.
Some jumping around, some dancing, some crazy. You know?
Alistair, go ahead.
I feel like I've created too relaxed an atmosphere.
Good, how are you?
Yeah.
I'm the one you're burned, though.
Yeah. You're on the air.
Tom or Andy, I'm just waiting on the phone, too.
By the way, so you know, Andy, we are 6 minutes
you?
Over now. It's now 9:06. We can go until you feel
that's
we...
That's so weird.
I want to hang out more. Yeah. I love it. I'm having the best
Halifax.
Time.
Halifax, they just said my name.
Okay, two callers right. Talking to each other. All right. This is
let me hear him.
Oh, okay, well, I hung up already. We're having
you
some fun.
Up,
I don't know who this is.
Buddy?
I'm hanging up on this person, too. I'm sorry for hanging up on some of these people. Chris from New York. Chris from New York? No, okay. I don't know. Mike from Pembroke.
Just give the whole bag to me.
Andy.
I worked out a lot today.
Andy.
What?
I want you to put on some shorts because we're tired of looking. I mean, I want you to put on some pants because we're tired of looking at your chicken legs.
What?
He's saying
we're tired of looking at Andy's chicken legs and you should put on some pants.
Put on some pants, he's saying.
How about this? How about I take off from him and show you my nutsack, you fucking asshole. These are chicken legs. I had to go to the chiropractor because they said I overdeveloped my calf and it's pulling my tendon away from my bone. You can look at my salty nutsack, you fucking asshole.
I don't even want to look at that thing. Get it out of my face.
Then turn your computer off. Put it to sleep. Restart. Do whatever you want.
Fight me.
Go back to MySpace.com.
Fight me, Andy. I'll fight you right now.
Fuck you.
Fight me.
Fight yourself, you fucking
I fight myself. I'll fight you.
Oh, that kid was from Pembroke. That's the town I was born in.
No.
Yeah, for real.
Was he your friend?
No. Never met the guy. Mike from Pembroke.
Well, that's what's going to be on YouTube tomorrow, and all the kids from my daughter's and my son's soccer games watch YouTube,
yeah.
And they come up to me, and they say, I love Zitty Me, and I go, and I do it for them, and now they're going to go, why are you yelling at him and trying to show him your salty nutsack?
Yeah, well,
it's not going to be good, because I'm a soccer dad.
I think they understand that it's humor, that it's comedy.
Ooh,
the Cheetos as well.
Right.
Alexandria from California.
Hello?
Yeah, Alexandria from California. Yeah, you're on the air.
Hey, what's up, man? I have a question. I'm so happy to be talking to Andy Dick, but my question is, have you ever had any surgery on any part of your body, anywhere?
It's a good question. Thank you. A responsible, a likable sounding girl. Let's have a hand for Alexandria. Alexandria, thank you.
I don't remember how long ago, like about a year ago, I was in a bar and I got punched in the nose, and I had stitches, 9 stitches in the shape of a crucifix.
Yeah.
She can't hear me?
Yeah, Alexandria, hello? can you hear Andy?
Yeah.
Yeah, he got a...
Well, then stop saying hello.
Why is it... Yeah, I was talking about how...
I had to go to the hospital because I got my nose broken. It wasn't surgery. They just sewed it up and that was it. It's actually crooked now. It's a little bit like an Owen Wilson nose. You can see the scarring.
Was that purpose? On purpose? You tried to get the Owen Wilson nose on purpose?
No.
You go out looking for a fight just because you want to look like Owen Wilson or something?
No. It was one of the worst. I hate it.
Is that how
it
is?
But no, I've never had any plastic. I'm 40 years old. So the only thing that I do to make me look younger is to dye my gray hair. And, you know, do you have gray hair?
I'm starting to get a few. Yeah. Starting to get a few.
You're 6 years younger. You're 34. I'm 34, 40.
Yeah. Well, you know, I wouldn't have guessed you had to be 40, you know. Noah from Maine.
Yeah.
I don't want these.
Andy, what's your favorite film? Send me your favorite film.
Favorite film?
I was just thinking about this film today called Chinatown, or went recently. Chinatown's one of my favorite films ever. Yeah. Have you ever seen it?
You know what? I have a long time ago.
It's really good. What about you know what it's about? The San Fernando fucking Valley.
It is, huh?
It's about all this that we can see with.
I gotta go see that one again.
Yeah, you forgot
that.
You were so young,
probably.
Oh yeah, but one of his best movies ever.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
It's what I think that movie is the one that made him just a star.
Yeah.
Well, Easy Rider, I guess. I don't know.
Wasn't that The Kid Stays in the Picture produced that movie? You know that guy.
Zanuck or whatever.
Yeah.
Hey, no. Or Evan.
Yeah, you know the guy. Robert Evans.
Robert Evans.
Yeah.
Really?
Chinatown? I don't know.
He might have. Man, it was... I was thinking about it because
Google,
I was
email
thinking,
us in the email section and tell us if
I was trying to think of the director.
Chinatown, yeah.
And it was Roman Polanski.
Oh,
and
well,
he's in it.
No, that's
he's
right.
The guy that slits his... He puts a knife up Jack Nicholson's nose and then goes... And slits that part. And then it looked so... I don't know how they did it.
Do that again, the little... We got a nice shot of that.
Yeah. Well, he put a knife...
Splitting.
And up the nose, and he's holding it there, and you think, oh, he's just being intimidating with the knife. But then at the very end, you better do it,
there
I say.
There we go, look at that. Slits it right
and he
off.
Just, no, he doesn't slit it off. He just slits that piece of skin
Look at that,
right
look at that, that's a good one, look at that. Right,
he slits
right
that piece of skin.
What's that
right
part
there
of the nose? Look at that. That's the part of the nose that gets slit in Chinatown.
Right there.
Look at that, a great shot. Look at that. That doesn't even look like you, man.
Well,
glance over there. That doesn't even look like you at that
I can't glance over.
You look at that?
I'm trying to...
You look like a completely... You don't.
Well, everybody would look like a completely
different
person.
But that
does
not look like Andy Dick to me right there. Honestly. Cut back to an Andy Dick.
You do it.
Let's have an Andy Dick.
Get on him.
Okay, I'll do it.
Do it. Then we'll see if it looks like you.
All right. So honestly, look how it changes.
Get on him.
Look.
No, close up.
Closer.
it still looks like... It still looks like you, buddy.
Yeah. Alicia from Halifax. Alicia from Halifax, you're on the air.
Hey, guys, how's it going?
We're doing good. Oh, look, you can see that in the 20-second delay there. I have a deviated septum, you know that?
Ew, gross. What does this mean, an entertainment?
That's the name of the book. Yeah, I don't know. It's something.
Well, what is this part then? P.S. Jack Parr.
They were very highfalutin back there. You know,
and entertain.
Yeah, they were very. Look at
that. That is pretentious.
It is.
Dude.
Yeah. But that was what he was known for, being quite pretentious. And he had a whole thing about him. And you'd hang out with the Kennedys, and just was a real kind of cocky guy. You know, he walked off the show once.
He did.
Live.
Why?
Because he made a joke. Using that was a pun, essentially, joking about the wayside chapel, and he made a joke between that and a water closet, and it was sort of a sacrilegious joke. You know, water closet.
Are people booed?
The network, NBC, didn't air it.
And that's why he walked
off. Or they cut it out of a later broadcast or something like that.
He
and
should have understood.
He should have, yeah.
Because that's pretty,
he was a little,
especially back then.
He wore his heart on his sleeve, sometimes
like,
to his fault.
Like I do and you do.
Yeah.
You do, and then people think you're joking, you know. And then you just go that route. I do, too, in a lot of ways.
Yeah.
Like just back there, I was telling you, I started to tell you some of my problems, and you said, I don't believe a word you're saying. But but it was all true.
No, but now I do believe. Because, okay. You know, I didn't realize. I thought you were doing a bit, that's all.
But I'm never doing a bit.
Never.
That's the whole bit.
Did
smoke come out of my fingers?
Did you like Andy Kaufman?
I gotta work on that shit. Smoke was supposed to come out. Let me try it again.
Did you follow Andy Kaufman?
Let me try it again. Fuck. I paid for it. Who's there? She's coughing. She's on the phone. What do you want? She's coughing. Like, hello, I'm still
here. Alicia from Halifax.
I'm still here.
She has a question.
What's going on?
Well, nothing.
Well, then why did you cough and make us pay attention to you?
So I had a question.
What?
I was wondering how you like doing old school.
It was fun.
How was that?
And she wants to know what Will Ferrell was like, it says. Here.
The mouse peed in your mouth.
In Road Trip, yeah.
Yeah.
She meant the old school one.
I mixed them both up.
With Will Ferrell.
Yeah, they're both by Todd Phillips.
It says here, what did you like Will Ferrell? And I'm sure...
Oh, he was great. He's super sweet. I remember saying to him, man, you're so funny. I need more people like you in my life. And then I never saw him again.
We should call him. Do you have any friends that you could call?
We did that.
Like no, tomorrow. I mean,
yes,
to get
yes. Well,
say,
I'm not
hey,
coming tomorrow.
No, but
once a week. I already feel good for about 7 days now.
No, I'm saying to get some other people for us. Thanks, Alicia. You know, like people just say, hey, it was a good time. It was fun.
Bob will do it. Yeah, Bob Odenkirk, David Cross will do it.
Oh, that'd be awesome.
I'll call him.
You know,
not now. Let's save it.
Tell him, you know, it's a chill time and it's fun.
I'll love it.
Just relax.
All my friends will do it. Janine will do it.
Yeah,
all the people from the Ben Stiller show will do it.
That'd be amazing. Pat from Long Island. I'm trying to get a guests for next week here. I'm haranguing our
no,
guests.
No, that's a smart idea. Yeah. I can.
Well, we're just kind of, you know what,
Pat?
We're trying to produce it on the air, you know. People are emailing us and they email us at the
I feel like I should call him now, David Cross.
Call him right now. I did this poker show once with him and I wasn't at all on it.
Oh, the celebrity poker.
I was so uncomfortable because I wanted to win the poker and then ended up losing the poker and was so embarrassed and just basically it was not a proud moment for me. Pat from Long
Island. I have 9 missed calls.
Pat from Long Island.
Tom?
Yes, Pat.
Hey, Andy, are you doing another season of The Assistant anytime soon?
You're going to do another season of The Assistant?
No, that was also another one of my canceled shows. Thanks, everybody, for bringing up all the shows that have been canceled.
It's hard getting canceled. It doesn't feel good. When we did the new Tom Green show, which you came on and you broke my friend's thumb and we had a lot of fun there. Andy, you know, they canceled that and it stung, I tell you. I didn't enjoy it. But, you know, you move on and, you know.
Oh, sure.
You do other stuff, you know.
What are you saying? Okay. I just have 9 messages.
You know
what
I like? I sometimes like just kind of wallowing in the fact that there's no commercial break.
No, we can go on forever.
We could sit here.
We could sit here in silence. Hours. Let's do that.
We could put the masks on or the wigs on, you know, and just start to get a little sillier with it.
Just let's be silent with it though.
Yeah. Pass me a wig if you could or something.
Let's just do both wigs and we'll just sit here.
Yeah.
No reason why not to. I mean, there's wigs
there.
I
have to fart.
Oh, great.
We have wigs. We have glasses here, you know?
I don't want him to have to smell.
Let's see here, what do we got? Do you sing at all, Andy? You sing in your band,
right?
Everybody
sings. I'll sing a song.
I mean, I don't really know. I don't sing, but I can play a guitar. We could do a little number. Can you improvise something over this? Would you like to do that?
Sure. Do you have glasses for me?
Do we have some glasses for Andy?
If you don't, that's okay.
Some sunglasses for Andy. Here, you're watching Tom Green live on Mania TV. Oh, those are some cool glasses. Look at this.
Well, they're the same ones.
Is that something that works, or?
Hey, oh, hey, oh, yeah. Yeah, it worked for Nirvana.
Ah! Okay, okay.
Can we do something new? Tom, Dr. Tom, you make me happy with your pills of wisdom and knowledge. Oh, Dr. Tom, I'd like to pledge my love to you! Ah! Ah! doctor, are you in or out? 'Cause I'm out of my mind. I need you, doctor, to bring me back.
Should we take a couple more calls and then...
Let's go hang out private, yeah.
Yeah, how about we just end the show now?
We got a couple girls in the hot tub. Next time we should, next time we should put them on camera. You should get a camera set up out
there.
Yeah,
let's get out
on... He said, I don't want to get the cameras wet. He didn't want to... We got like three girls out there, half naked, in the hot tub, and he's embarrassed about that. Next time we're putting the camera out there. I'm not fucking kidding around either.
Say if it's true or not.
You put a light out there.
Thanks for tuning in, everybody. It's been a lot of fun. Andy, thanks for coming.
I love you, dude.
You're gonna come back.
Every week, dude.
Okay,
doctor. I need some doctor.
Thank you. You've been watching Tom Green.
I need
Green
the doctor's pills.
On Media TV and TomGreen.com. See ya.
Get your beer.
Okay, yeah.
Get your beer.
I have a blog, and the callers get angry at me.
What do they say?
They write up and they say, you don't take any calls.
We're going to take calls, but we're going to talk a little bit. I haven't seen Tom in 2 years.
Yeah, they say, you don't take any calls. We're calling all night. No one takes any calls ever. And then they get mad about that. And then when I do take calls and they say stupid stuff that makes no sense, so I cut them off or hang up on them. And then they call them and they say that I'm rude and they say that I'm an ass.